Okay, before we start this video, all I wanted to say was this is not a tutorial by any means. This is just how I develop my film, just like the title says, this is me developing my film. So, yeah, now that that's out of the way, that this isn't a tutorial, today we're going to be developing Kodak Tri-X. We're going to be developing 400 ISO Tri-X film. Let's see if this goes in focus. Okay, it's in focus. So yeah, we're developing 400 ISO Kodak Tri-X. It's black and white negative film. So what that means is when you get it developed, the image is going to be negative. So it's not going to be what you see. So you're going to have to do some image processing or image editing. So this is the film I'm using. I'm going to be using a Patterson tank to develop. And I'm going to be using Kodak HC110, Ilford Rapid Fixer, and Kodak PhotoFlow. Oh my gosh, why isn't this in focus? I'm not sure if it's in focus. I don't look like I'm in focus, but who cares? Because this is just having fun. So let me set up my camera so where I'm going to be putting my film into the development tank. And we'll go from there. So yeah. Okay, so hopefully this is a good angle because I could see my monitor right here, but like it's really tiny, so I can't really see. So now we're gonna be putting my film into our development tank. So first thing we need to do is we need to remove my watch because that has light and you cannot expose your film. So this, my watch, my Galaxy watch, I have to put right here. Okay, now our next thing we need to do is we need to cut this lead. So the lead that's on your film, you have to cut it. So I'm using these scissors. So let me cut it. Okay. So I cut my lead. My lead is right here. You could throw it away or do whatever you want with it. Like, okay, now here's our film. So don't make sure not to, okay, you could pull it out a little bit, it's fine. But don't make sure not to pull out the whole thing because then you'll like expose it to the light and then your film is no good. But like, here's our lead. Or like, where our film begin. Here's our Patterson developing tank. So all you need to bring is, you don't need to bring the lid or the little, I forgot what the twiddle stick, or whatever it's called. All you need is this lid and your reels. So your reels is where your film goes. So let me show you. So your film goes in here and you just do a twisting motion and that's how you that's how you put your film on your reels. So now that all this is here, we have to put it into the bag. So just as I said, I put the reels in here but I still haven't put my film in there. So I'm just gonna bring the tank and my Patterson tank into our life proof bag. Oh, I also bring my scissors with me because at the end of the roll, it's stuck to the roll or to the thing. So yeah, let me open our changing bag and then put our Patterson tank in here. And here's our film. Let me put our film in there and then close it. And then let me put the Velcro back on and then let me put my hand through here. Oh no, I forgot my scissors. So let me put the scissors before we begin. Also, sometimes if your film, the whole lead goes inside your film, you're gonna need this to open it, but good thing that didn't happen. So we don't need that. So now, we're ready to begin. We put our hands into the bag. So, yeah, let's start with that. Okay, our next hand is in here. Let me just make sure it's all the way in here. Okay, now let me see. Okay, here's our Patterson tank, and right here is our film. So let me open the Patterson tank and get our film reel out. I might speed this up because this is pretty boring. Because all it is just me finding the reel and then trying to put our film in there. And that's pretty boring. But if you want to watch, might speed this up, I might, depending on how long this takes. So, yeah. Okay, now that it's sealed, we can remove our hands from the bag. Okay, look at my hands. They have marks. And then we can open our bag. And here's our tank. We cannot open it now because then that will expose our film, and that would not be good. Okay, so here's, wow. This is how much is left. Please focus, camera. Okay, you see? That's how much I cut. So, let me just put this. So this is empty. There's nothing in here. So now that that's out of the way. Now that that's out of the way, I'll show you the developing chemicals or how to develop now. So yeah. Okay, so now where I develop. So our chemicals we have is our developer. This is Kodak HC-110. This is our developer. First, I rinse my film, and then I use my developer. This is a 1 to 31 ratio. So one part 31 millimeters, one part of HC-110, 31 parts water. Okay, so it's 31 milliliters of HC-110. And 969 milliliters of water. Okay, you cannot dispose any of these chemicals down the drain because it's bad for wildlife, as you can see right here. Look, please focus again. Okay, thank you. It's focusing. So I store my chemicals, my used chemicals into plastic bottles, and then I get them disposed of properly. So here's my fixer, which is the next chemical. I use Ilford Rapid Fixer. It's in this chemical. It's in this one because you could use it like about 7 times. And then my last chemical is Kodak PhotoFlow. Once again, I put my PhotoFlow in a bottle. And this is a 1 to 200 part. I'm not going to be showing you how to mix it because that's pretty boring. And also, you're gonna need a thermometer and gloves and a mask. So, yeah. And also you're gonna need a timer. So, let me just mix my chemicals now. So, I'll go back when I'm ready. Okay, I'm not sure if you can hear me correctly because I'm wearing a mask. But here it goes. So, right now I'm wearing a 3M half respirator, half face mask. And I'm wearing medical gloves because these chemicals are skin irritants and also they're pretty strong. So that's why I'm wearing a mask. So you have to be careful with these chemicals. I haven't mixed yet, So let me remove this. I'm not sure if you, hopefully you can hear me better. I unbuckled the strap. But we're gonna be start mixing now after I put my mask on. So yeah. So now I'm gonna start mixing. So I'm gonna be quiet now. Once I set up my camera. So yeah. And put my face mask on. Cause this is pretty hard. Well, for me. Especially when wearing gloves. So let's get that started.
We have readings over Kansas that were very pleasant today. However, we are looking for a new front to begin to drift south and eastward. The central and eastern parts of Kansas will very probably be cloudy in the morning, and then western Kansas will begin to get increasing cloudiness by tomorrow afternoon. Today, however, very, very pleasant reading. 73 up in the Goodland area, 72 at Garden City, 70 reported by Dodge City and Liberal, 72 over by the good folks of Garden. Winds southerly at about 15 with gusts of 25 miles an hour. Barometric pressure 30.00 and is rising. And no precipitation. We're about a half inch behind, correction, half inch ahead for the year, and 1 53 hundredths behind for the year so far. We'll be looking for a little bit of a change tomorrow, and of course the possibility of some scattered showers. Today, of course, there's nothing showing up on the radar. However, the satellite photo was pretty interesting for the western half of the U.S. Rain showers and thunder showers along that frontal system. That wide band of fairly heavy snow is now what will happen. Each time that you see the frontal system on there, that begins at 6 o'clock in the morning, and then you'll see the cloud pattern move until 2 o'clock this afternoon. So as of that time, of course, the front was way off in the northwest. Now, however, it's moving into the central part of the nation with a couple of high-pressure set cells behind it.
Okay, I'm not sure if you could hear this because of the microphone I'm using. Here I am, right here. I'm using my Rode video mic, micro, and my Lumix G7. But here's my film. I'm developing it, well, drying it right here. Here are some of the photos. Let me show you some. Let me turn on my flashlight so you can see. Here are some of the photos. Hopefully you can see them. Nope, you can't see them, but like, here are some of them. And they turned out pretty good. So once they're done drying, I'll digitize them, and then I'll show you. So yeah. Thank you. Okay, I know the lighting here is horrible, but this is where I'm doing my video editing. Editing the video right here. But all I wanted to say was those were the photos. I had really fun developing them and digitizing them. And I hope you like this video. So, yeah. Bye.